Civics. It is the study of the rights and duties of citizenship. You know, you're all upset because of the presidential election is kind of looking like a circus sideshow. You're mad at the games being played by the people who lead our state government. You want to know how to fix all that's wrong and broken in our government. Civics, my friend. If more people fulfilled their responsibility as American citizens, let me tell you, things would be a lot better run around here. But where does it begin? You know where? With our youth. And the first step to make them better and more active citizens is knowledge, specifically understanding just how government works. Well, I'm here to tell you something about that. It's pretty exciting. Behold, Envision Chicago. And we're going to be, by the way, demoing this in a few minutes. It is, in a nutshell, a learning tool and scholarship program just now being launched in four Chicago high schools. It is a door that unlocks for students the mysteries of how municipal government works in Chicago. So where did this site come from? How does it work? Will it really make a difference? Let's find out. I'm accompanied by two champions of this very project. Chicago City Clerk Susana Mendoza and the Executive Director of something called the Open Gov Foundation, Seamus Kraft.
Good to be here.
What is the Open Gov Foundation?
We're a nonprofit that works with governments like the City of Chicago to bring lawmaking into the internet age. We essentially turn this, your paper-based laws, into something that you can access, understand, and use on this.
Susana, get me excited about Envision Chicago. Pump me up. Why should I care?
I mean, first of all, happy St. Patrick's Day, Seamus.
It's a good day to be a Seamus.
Number two, like he shamelessly is turning boring code that is on paper and by the reams into like super cool way to access your government via online, whether it's through your smartphone or just your computer, however you want to do it. We're trying to make government somewhat actually cool. I know it's hard to believe, but we're excited about this. We think it's super fun. Seamus here prides himself in being a little tech nerd, but he's actually one of the coolest guys I know, and he's working with the City of Chicago and trying to bring students into a fun way of becoming participants in their civic government.
So it was your organization, Seamus, that first came up with the concept. You reached out to the City. Chicago's the first. You have a dozen and a half or so that are picking up the ball here. Sounds like there's a lot of a groundswell of support and excitement about it. Where did the idea come from? Did it dawn on you and others that, wow, kids, they just don't get how this works? You know, they can actually empower themselves to take part.
Well, technology is the infrastructure, the critical infrastructure of our daily lives, of our work lives, and why not our civic lives? And no one understands that better than students who live their lives on their smartphones. And if government isn't meeting the next generation of our leaders where they are on the internet, they're not going to know what to do when they're in charge.
And you were the guy helping Congress understand how to better use social media and other technology that was
Absolutely.
Used by you and others on the Obama administration team.
Well, this all came out of our experience as frustrated public servants who didn't have the tools to do our jobs. And that's what Clerk Mendoza has been leading the way on inside of the clerk's office in Chicago, now the full council. And really, the first digital legislature in the entire country is going to be the Windy City.
You would have thought it, right? But Chicago is A1 on this stuff right now.
But why Chicago is first?
Chicago is one of the most engineered, community-focused places on Earth. What better place to plant a flag for better government and for future government than this?
That's right.
So how do we know it's going to work? We're going to see how it works in just a minute, but has it been test marketed somehow?
Look, you should have been at those schools with us today. Those kids were so pumped up. They were totally excited. It was like just food for my soul, frankly. And we know that given the opportunity to like tell students that we actually care about their ideas, and that they themselves can help make Chicago a better city every day by just communicating with us in a way that's easy and like it's so simple for them. They know it better than we do. So like we want them to be a part of this. They want to be a part of this, and we saw it today.
All right. How did you see it? What were they doing? How were they actually actively engaged in how government works?
So they were asking great questions. They were like looking forward to seeing, well, I'm going to be, you know, you're going to be, you know, they were in. First of all, we're giving $1,000 scholarships. So the four brightest ideas that come out of this are going to actually have some money attached to them. But more importantly, like you should have seen, they were asking their teachers, when are we going to meet next about this? It's really kind of fun to see that when given an opportunity to actually get engaged, they will. I think, you know, oftentimes the only thing students want is actually to be heard and to believe that they have a voice. And they have a huge voice through this Envision Chicago program.
Envision Chicago, it's rolling out at four schools. Marine Leadership Academy, Chicago Excel Academy, Taft High, and Lakeview High School. You were at Lakeview today?
We were at Lakeview today, and we were also at Marine Leadership Academy. And I mean, this competition is on, but we have every reason to believe that this is going to catch like wildfire, and all 50 wards will hopefully be represented
in
Chicago very soon. Yeah.
And it'll be part of the curriculum, right? For year by year, it'll be part of the natural process of learning how government works. Seamus, the process is to change and look at and understand laws, right?
Mm-hmm.
Tell me about that. The kids can actually go in and see what a law looks like and suggest changes.
The whole point of what we've done with the clerk and what Envision Chicago is to lower the barrier between a high school student or any citizen and the city's most important information. It's laws, it's legislation. That is the core data set for the city of Chicago.
And that sounds kind of intimidating. We rarely get a chance to even look at laws. And I think, Susanna, you were telling me that in some cities, you have to pay
exactly.
to see the actual text of the law.
The laws belong to you. They don't belong to me. So we keep the records, but they should be free and open to the public.
Have you seen it put into play where actually students have come forward with ideas and made suggestions that were sensible and became implemented?
Absolutely. We test ran Envision in San Francisco last year. And the ideas that students came up with were not just good, they were great. They actually became laws that are now on the books in the city of San Francisco, making it a better city. Who knows where a good idea for government is going to come from?
What could this be the Kickstarter for, Susanna? These kids get fired up about this, leading to...
Look, I mean, some of these kids are going to end up being the next mayors, the next aldermen, the next representatives, could be the next president. And
well,
that's
what's
exciting.
Pretty boastful that this is going to have
for
that
sure.
broad and deep
Why
of
not?
An impact.
Of course. Like, when people get involved in their government, they own that government and they own their own lives. So, like, today I asked kids a question. How many of you are proud of the city that you live in? And while most of them said that they were, there were a couple that said they weren't. And I said, this program is going to give you the ability to once again feel proud about your city, because you yourself can make a difference by sharing those ideas with us about what you would do differently if you were in my shoes.
Yeah,
I think it's really important to remember that everybody's upset right now with their government. People are angry. People are frustrated. People are looking for a place to have a productive conversation.
Yeah.
And that very much includes young Chicagoans who can be disengaged, disenfranchised, and ultimately distrust their own government. This is about rebuilding that trust through technology.
All right. I want to see how it works. So, in fact, what we're going to do, we're going to take this sort of fresh off the assembly line website for a spin around our online outlook.
Super easy.
Yeah. So we'll take a break now, get our seatbelts ready for the roll, and we'll be back to do that in just a minute here on Politics Tonight.